When the ancient Greeks first developed the geocentric model, the Earth-centered model of the heavens, Aristotle postulated that Earth was stationary at the center of all the orbits, and that all planets orbited the Earth in one direction and with steady motions. Which means that if we looked out at the night sky at a planet, we would expect it to move in one direction across the sky. But that is not what we see planets do. And in this top image, we see the motion of a planet across the sky, probably Mars. And you see by the numbers that it begins moving in one direction, kind of slows down, then reverses direction, and then reverses direction again. The portion where it is apparently moving backwards is the part of the motion that is called retrograde. And the part where it's moving forward, these two sections here, shade that in a little darker, that's called prograde motion. So retrograde motion is backwards motion. Prograde is forward motion. So that original model of planets going around the Earth in one direction with one speed clearly did not match the observation. So here's a case in the scientific method where revision was necessary. So they did not revise and get rid of the geocentric model. Instead, they modified the geocentric model. And the person who did this modification was Claudius Ptolemy. The P is silent. And what he added was an extra circle. So if we look at our bottom diagram here, we've got the Earth in the center, not moving. And this first big circle is called the deferent. So that's what the original geocentric model pictured as the orbit. So the planet would have been on that deferent, and it would have been going around the Earth. What Ptolemy added was the second circle, which he called an epicycle. And so now the planet, labeled with the P, is on the epicycle, and the epicycle is being carried by the deferent around the Earth, and then the planet is rotating on the epicycle. So what we're going to get is a combination of motions. So I've cleaned up my picture so that we could see more clearly what's happening. As our epicycle orbits around the Earth and the planet moves on the epicycle, from our point of view on Earth, we're going to see the planet moving forward, then backwards, then forward again. Let me clean that up without all the little circles. So what it would look like is moving forward, backwards, forward, backwards. And our planet would be following this loop-de-loop around the Earth. And notice that when it's going backwards is when it would be closer to Earth. All these little loops as it comes in closer to Earth would show it moving backwards. And when it's going forward is when it's on the far side of the epicycle. And this model went through a lot of different modifications over the years. Extra epicycles were added. The center of the deferent was actually moved a little bit away from the Earth. But amazingly enough, they were able to modify this model so that they could predict planet positions very accurately many, many years in advance. And remember, in the scientific method, one of the biggest tests to see if your hypothesis is correct is, do your predictions come true? And in this case, this model, as crazy as it looks, the predictions did come true. And so it was an accepted theory. And it actually was held in accepted theory status for about 1500 years before it was finally thrown out for the heliocentric model. So that just goes to show you that even some accepted theories are not necessarily true, even if they do work well.